What happened in the other districts where marijuana has become criminalized more for tourists? What effect did it have on the community?
Well, it criminalized the whole scene. You know, it's an easy game. The coffee shop, it was legal, it was perfect, and now there are street dealers waiting for the tourists. They already were there, of course, but now it's exploded. You know, the guys are everywhere. And they're not only selling weed, they're selling hard drugs, they're selling all kinds of stuff. They're intimidating people. It's the worst nightmare ever, you know. And the worst thing is, people could see it coming, you know. Everybody knew this is going to happen. It's crazy policy.
Meneer!
Gek!
Ik heb niks gedaan.
Lekker voor je.
What's your name and introduce yourself?
Yes, my name is Eric. I'm the cameraman and editor of JDTV, a Dutch YouTube station.
And can you tell us about what happened here in Holland with the changing marijuana legislation and laws?
As a result of that, lots of coffee shops lost their customers, and those people went to street dealers, and the whole scene changed, the whole game changed, and especially in the city of Maastricht, in the south of the Netherlands.
What have you observed?
Well, like I personally filmed a guy who threatened me and a coffee shop holder with a knife, because the coffee shops went open for foreigners again out of protest. They won a lawsuit or a case in a court, and after that they reopened, and the street dealer came to the coffee shop and threatened the coffee shop owner because he wasn't satisfied with him being open again, you know. And I saw a group of street dealers, and they were being intimidated by another street dealer. He was like acting up and being all tough guy, and you know, I saw he was going to do something. So I switched on my camera, I started following him, and I saw him starting to argue with the coffee shop owner. Well, I tried to film him, and I retreated behind the window so I could film him better. And then he pulled a knife on the coffee shop owner, and yeah, he started threatening him because he was taking his business away. So yeah, and then it escalated, and he saw me. He started threatening me, bouncing on the window, and yeah, saying bad things about my mother. So yeah, it was really bad, you know. And in first instance, I was observing him from behind the window. I said, guys, let's get him, but we had to wait for the police, and then we went after him. And yeah, it was a crazy scene. We ended in a parking garage where the guy got maced and worked to the ground, and yeah, then he went to jail.
Ik heb niks gedaan.
But I've heard at the moment that his case, he's gone free. There's not enough evidence. It's crazy. Those are scenes, you know. The people of Maastricht face it every day, and it's getting more threatening every day. It's getting worse, and the policies by the local government, you know, it's like they're living in fantasy land.
What's been going on here in some of the smaller towns other than Amsterdam?
Well, essentially what happened was the former coalition government, which came into power like maybe 5 years ago, it was a coalition of three very nasty parties: Christian Democrats, free market capitalists, and literally just neo-Nazi fascists. These three came together, and one of the things that they did not like was in the south of the Netherlands, where you have the Belgium and the German border, people come, they buy weed, and they leave. This creates a lot of flow, a lot of traffic. Now, residents down south, they weren't too keen on this neither. It did cause a lot of problems, a lot of nuisances. what they tried to do was impose a national policy whereby coffee shops would have to be closed, and to enter a coffee shop you would have to be a paid registered member, and to register you have to be registered in a city council at the gemeente. This was opposed by most other cities. The mayor of Amsterdam came out in opposition against it. The mayor of Maastricht originally supported it. From the 1st of May last year, it was implemented in the south of the Netherlands as an experiment, and it was due to come to the rest of the country 1st of January 2013. Within 3 months, the mayor came out and said he wants to do a U-turn. Why? Because all of the dealing and all of the drug sales went onto the streets. So what you had there was people on the streets, they don't care about ages, they don't care about quality, and they also don't care about selling hard drugs. This caused such a big problem that crime went up. And it's really quite sad because we all knew it was going to happen, but the difference between public opinion and public policy cannot be any more clear when you look at cannabis, because they put in there claiming it was going to have this effect, when really claiming it was going to lower consumption. You know, the idea of Ivo Opstelten was close the coffee shops, people just won't buy weed. It is obvious it was going to fail, but sadly we had to have this policy implemented, we had to see the disastrous effects, and then we had to reverse on it.
Voor de camera nog. Ik wil niet op de camera. Ik wil niet op de camera.
Can you tell us what kind of cancer you had and how did the cannabis extract help you?
Well, I had a specific form of lung cancer.
This is Luke Radowski of WeAreChange.org reporting to you in Holland. And a lot of people here are telling me about cannabis oil. I've heard in the United States many people use cannabis oil to treat very similar